Yeah, can we start? Okay, so next slide down, calculation of work done. Okay, so the first case we are taking, first of all, we are considering expansion over here. Right, in case of expansion, we are considering. So the process we have that we are assuming is isothermal expansion. So how do we calculate work done in case of isothermal expansion process? That is what we are going to see. And after this, we'll see adiabatic. Okay. So isothermal expansion means delta T is zero, temperature is not changing, which means change in internal energy is equals to zero, because internal energy is a function of temperature only. Okay, for gases, it is a function of temperature only. If temperature is constant, delta U is equals to zero. In fact, delta H also equals to zero at constant temperature for gases. This is two things. Correct? Delta U is zero, there is no change in internal energy, means the amount of heat absorbed by the system, right, plus Q, equal amount of work done by the systems, minus W is equals to plus Q. This is what the condition we have, right? Amount of heat absorbed by the system, equal amount of work the system has to do, so that there is no net gain or loss of energy by the system, and hence the internal energy remains constant. Okay, this is the property here. Now, we have isothermal expansion, and what we are considering? We are considering, first of all, the first case is that the process is irreversible. Irreversible process. Correct. And what happens in irreversible process? P external is what? Variable or constant? Irreversible. What is P external? P external is constant. Okay, P external is constant. This is the property we'll use, right? See, expansion also, we have of two types. Expansion we have of two types. Just one simple word, nothing much. You don't have to study, you know, think much about over here. One is free expansion and other one is intermediate expansion. Free expansion is what? Free expansion is like expansion in vacuum. Expansion in vacuum. Correct? Where there is no external pressure. Right? There's no external pressure. And since there is no external pressure, work done is also zero in case of free expansion. That is it. Nothing you need to think about. Okay, there's no external pressure, hence work done is zero. The other type of expansion we have is intermediate expansion. Intermediate expansion means we have just intermediate pressure, means expansion is taking place against a constant external pressure. So work done in this process is what? It's very simple. Whatever the external pressure we have, work done is equals to minus P external dV. We integrate this from V1 to V2. Since the process is irreversible, P external is constant. So we'll take minus P external out of the integral sign. That is dV, V1 to V2. So the work done in case of intermediate expansion is equals to minus P external delta V, which is V2 minus V1. Clear? See, what would be the condition of maximum work done in intermediate irreversible expansion process, irreversible isothermal expansion. See, whenever you have piston cylinder system, right? So when external pressure is more, work done will be more, right? So work done will be maximum when external pressure is equal to the pressure of the gas, right? So maximum work done, the condition is what? Just in this note, you write down. For maximum work done, P external would be equals to the pressure of the gas. Because further you decrease pressure, external pressure, work done will also decrease. So this is the condition where the P external is maximum, and here the work done will be maximum. So this is intermediate expansion for irreversible process. Copied? Okay. Now the same adiabatic, but the condition we have reversible isothermal process. Reversible isothermal process. In reversible isothermal process, we know since the process is reversible, so P external is not constant. Look at this system over here. We have a piston cylinder system. We have gas here. So this is the external pressure, and this is the pressure of gas, the internal pressure, pressure of gas. Initially, what we are assuming, and the piston is movable, right? Up and down. There's no, piston is not fixed. So initially we have external pressure is equal to the pressure of gas when the piston is static, and that we are assuming as P initially. Now what do you do? You decrease the external pressure so that the expansion takes place. Correct. So what I'm just assuming here, if the external pressure, if P external reduces by dp amount, by dp, then the expansion is dv. Then the expansion is dv. And whenever you have expansion work done by the system, right? And this is the only case under which the expansion is taking place. We are considering expansion only here, right? So P external should be less. So what is the work done here in this process when you decrease the pressure? Work done would be minus P external, you decreases pressure by dp, and the volume would be dv, the change in volume. Okay, so work done dw is equals to minus P external into dv plus dp into dp, and dv both are very small, so this product will be even smaller. We can neglect this, right? We are neglecting the dp into dv term, and then we have to integrate it. So once we integrate it, you'll get the value of work done, the expression of work done in this process, minus P external into dv. We need to integrate it. So work done is zero initially. The volume is V1. When the volume is V2, the work done is W. This is the limit. And then when you solve this, P external we cannot take out because the process is what? Process is isothermal. And we know P external is not constant. Is not constant. Reversible, not isothermal, reversible. Okay, reversible process. Correct? So when you solve this, you'll get the expression as, I'll write down the expression, work done in reversible isothermal process is equals to minus 2.303 nRT log of V2 by V1, isn't it? This is a work done expression we have. Now the process is isothermal, correct? Isothermal process we have. So we can always write, P1 V1 is equals to P2 V2. So what is V2 by V1? V2 by V1 is nothing but P1 by P2. So instead of this V2 by V1, we can also place P1 by P2. So this is the expression in terms of volume. If expression in terms of pressure we need to write down, then work done in reversible isothermal process would be minus 2.303 nRT log of P1 by P2. Tell me, any doubt in this? Clear? Done? Okay, so this is for reversible isothermal expansion. Okay, condition you must remember, simply mugging up the formula won't help you. If you do not know, like, the formula is under which condition we have derived. Okay. Now you see the next condition we have, that is adiabatic expansion. The second one. We have adiabatic expansion. Okay, so delta Q for adiabatic process is zero. There is no exchange of energy. Means what? The system will do work at the cost of its own energy. If work done by the system, internal energy decreases. If work done on the system, internal energy increases. So what do you write down here? Write down the system does work at the cost of its own internal energy. Does work at the cost of its own internal energy. Right? If internal energy decreases, means work done by the system. If internal energy increases, work done on the system. We know this expression for one mole. Change in internal energy is equals to CV dT for one mole. Right? For one mole. And work done, W, is also equals to the change in internal energy. Because Q is zero. This is the expression we have. Okay. So this expression is what? It is work done is minus PdV and du is CV dT. This is the condition we have by which we can find out the condition of adiabatic expansion, adiabatic process actually. It is clear? Okay, first of all, we'll see the condition of work done and then we'll find out the internal, the condition of adiabatic process, and then we'll see the work done, expression for adiabatic expansion. Okay, so let's consider this expression first. You see, we have expression minus PdV is equals to CV dT. P we can write minus RT by V because PV is equals to nRT. CV dT. We are assuming N is equals to one mole. Correct. Now we can write minus R dV by V is equals to CV dT by T. And we integrate this. So it is T1 to T2, V1 to V2. Okay. Now R and CV we have, if you look at the expression of R by CV, could you find out the value of R by CV in terms of gamma? Tell me the value of R by CV in terms of gamma. How do you find out? See, what we have Cp minus Cv is equals to R. So we need to find out R by Cv, no? So we'll divide this side, both side will divide by Cv. Here also we have Cv and here also we have Cv. If you take this one by one, then Cp by Cv becomes gamma minus 1 is equals to R by Cv. So R by Cv is equals to gamma minus 1, which we can substitute here. Right? So the expression is log of V2 by V1. Right? And R by Cv, I'll write down here, gamma minus 1 is equals to negative of log of T2 by T1. Any doubt in this expression? See this first. R by Cv, I have written gamma minus 1. Minus sign, I'll put this side. dV by V is log of this and log of this. Correct? Any doubt? Okay. So this would be equals to V2 by V1 to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to T1 by T2. Can we write this? Yes. Further, can we write this? T1 V1 to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to T2 V2 to the power gamma minus 1. Y or N you can type quickly. So further, we can write T V to the power gamma minus 1 is equals to constant for adiabatic process. This is the condition we have. This condition in terms of, acha, one second Shraddha, I'll go back. Where? Previous slide, again, one more slide. This one. Here. Yeah, this I have written P, say, means we are assuming P. I wrote this. We are assuming P. Correct? Done, Shraddha. Yeah. Yeah, make not done. Okay. So this is the condition of adiabatic process. Very, very important. They've asked question on this many times. All the exam. Okay. This is in terms of T and V. Now we know this relation. PV is equals to NRT. So we have P V by T is equals to constant, and R are constant only. So you have T and V. So this temperature I can place in terms of pressure and volume. So what I can write, you see, temperature I can write will have some constant PV divided by some constant K. We can write this. If this constant, we have K. So instead of T, if you substitute here PV by K, you will get the expression in terms of pressure and volume. And that expression would be PV to the power gamma is equals to constant. This is the most important one. So we can write down the expression in terms of temperature and volume. We can write down the expression in terms of pressure and volume. If you substitute volume in terms of pressure and temperature, the expression we get in terms of pressure and temperature, right? So P and T, if you look at the expression here, P T to the power, T to the power gamma divided by 1 minus gamma is equals to constant. I'll write on it properly, wait. Or write down like this. P to the power 1 minus gamma into T to the power gamma is equals to constant. This is the expression for pressure and temperature. So any three, one of the three they can ask you. All three are important. This one is the most important one. This one, PV to the power gamma constant. The condition for a process to be adiabatic is this. Yeah, done all of you. So this is the condition for adiabatic. Now we need to find out the work done, right? That's what we were doing, right? So work done is equals to what? Work done is CV dT. This is the work done. Okay. CV is equals to, see, very simple expression we'll get. Just now we did R by CV is equals to gamma minus one, correct? Gamma minus one. So what is CV from here? R by gamma minus one. Just you substitute this here. We're just simplifying it, nothing much. R dT by gamma minus one. dT is, we can write T2 minus T1, the change in temperature basically, divided by gamma minus one. If you multiply R with T2 here, we'll get RT2 minus RT1 by gamma minus one, which further we can write W is equals to RT2 is P2 V2, RT1 is P1 V1 divided by gamma minus one. This is the work done expression for adiabatic process. Clear? Finished, all of you. Any doubt till here? Yeah. Now we'll see some questions. Okay, we have done, a lot, theory. Now you will get questions on all these. Whatever we have done on this, you'll get questions. So let's discuss a few questions here. Okay, one more thing. I forgot to discuss one concept of enthalpy. See, one last thing, 5 more minutes and then we'll see some questions. See, we are talking about enthalpy change. I had to discuss this just after enthalpy only, but you can write down here, that's not a problem. Enthalpy change in chemical reaction. When you have a chemical reaction, then how do we calculate the enthalpy change? See, enthalpy change, the formula we have is delta H is equals to delta U plus P delta V. For a chemical reaction, what we write, this P delta V is equals to delta N G R T. PV is equals to NRT. From PV is equals to NRT, we have written delta N G R T. This is the formula you need to use. Instead of PV, we have written NRT over here. Delta NG, just you need to take care of. Delta NG is the number of gaseous product minus the number of gaseous reactant. Only gas you need to consider. Solid and liquid you have to ignore over here. I'll write down a few examples. You see example one. When we have this reaction, N2 gas plus 3H2 gas gives 2NH3 gas. How do you find out delta NG here? Delta NG would be number of gaseous products. So moles just you need to consider. 2 moles of gaseous product minus 3 moles of reactant hydrogen and 1 mole of reactant N2. So we are getting minus 2. That means what? Delta NG is less than 0. When delta NG is less than 0, it means delta H is what? Delta H is less than delta U. Can we write down this? This is what we can conclude. Copied. This formula we use when there is chemical reaction given. Chemical reaction is involved, we use this formula. Consider this reaction, you see. We have CaCO3, the second example. CaCO3 is solid. When you heat this, it converts into CaO solid plus CO2 gas. Tell me the value of delta NG for this reaction. What is the value of delta NG? 1, right? This is zero, this is zero. We don't consider this. Greater than zero, which means what? Delta H is greater than delta U. This we can consider. And if for any reaction, delta NG is equals to zero, then the enthalpy change is nothing but the change in internal energy. Done, all of you? One second, Shraddha, I'll go back. Done, clear. Okay, so I guess all of you have copied down this. Let's discuss some questions. Try this. Eleven and Done. For 11th one, why you are taking that much of time? You see, 2 moles of an ideal gas, isothermal is there, right? So isothermal expansion has, so isothermal has a delta T is zero. When T is zero, so delta H is zero. What are you thinking? This is the answer. No. Yes. When you have isothermal, delta T is zero, delta U is zero. Clear? Tell me. K is just the unit, Kelvin, that is it. Here in question number 12, this K is just the unit Kelvin. You can ignore that. What is the answer? Question number 12. See, I'll do question number 12. Wait. See, the question is 1 mole of a monoatomic ideal gas expands. One second. 1 mole of a monoatomic ideal gas expands adiabatically at initial temperature T against a constant external pressure of 1 atm from 1 liter to 3 liter. Okay. So expands adiabatically. Correct. So first of all, it is an adiabatic process. So delta Q is equals to zero. And once this is zero, we know the change in internal energy is equals to the work done by the system, correct? Because it is an expansion, expands. So work done by the system, negative. Correct, means internal energy will decrease. Internal energy is what? We can write NCV delta T. Internal energy is NCV delta T. So NCV d delta T is equals to work done, which is given here. External pressure 1, 3 minus 1. Is it clear, this expression? Correct? Value of N is 1 mole, it is given. So 1 into CV is 3 by 2 R. Delta T is T final minus initial temperature T is equals to 3 minus 1, 2 into minus 1 minus 2. We need to find out this TF, correct? So TF minus T is equals to minus 2 divided by 1.5 R. I can write now. 3 by 2 is 1.5 R. Because I can see 1.5 is there in the denominator here. So TF is equals to T minus 2 divided by 1.5 into R is 0.0821. So option C is correct. Tell me, what is the doubt? So F is 3 only, no? That's what I have used. CV is F by 2R. F is 3 only. What is the value of F, Prakul? This one, right? See, this case just now I have discussed. In case of adiabatic process, delta Q is 0. So when you apply FLOT, first law of thermodynamics, FLOT, you will get this expression. Delta U is equals to minus W. What I have taken minus W here? Because it is a case of expansion. Expansion means work done by the system. Delta U, we know it is NCV dT. All the value I have substituted. N is 1, CV is 3 by 2R because it is monoatomic ideal gas. So 3 by 2R. Delta T is TF minus T. Final temperature minus initial temperature, which is T given over here. And work done is P external delta V. Find out TF from this. TV to the power gamma, you can find out temperature, but you won't get answer in this form. Are you getting any one of these two, A or B? TV to the power gamma, constant, we do not have the expression. The expression for temperature and volume, we have TV to the power gamma minus 1 constant. No, something similar to B or B, there's a difference. Okay, so if you are getting exactly B, then B could be the answer also. If not, then answer is not B. C is definitely answer. And the expression in terms of temperature and volume is TV to the power gamma minus 1 equals to constant. So you can think of this expression also. If you are getting B, then fine. Otherwise, you need to think like this. See, TF into volume. Final volume is what? 3. Gamma value is what for monoatomic gas? It is 5 by 3, correct? So 5 by 3 minus 1 is equals to initial temperature T and 1, whatever the power we have, it is 1 only. So TF is equals to, we are getting T divided by 3 to the power. Achha, in terms of R, we will substitute. So what is the value of gamma in terms of R? What is the value of gamma in terms of R? Could you tell me? Gamma in terms of R we have. Cp by Cv is equals to gamma, and Cp by Cv is, okay. Gamma in terms of R we do not have. We won't get B option. Right, so we'll get here Tf is equals to T divided by 3 to the power 2 by 3. Right? Now, if this 2 by 3 is equals to 5R by 2. If it is there, then answer option B is also possible here. Which is obviously not, because it is more than this. So this order is not correct. And hence option B is not possible. But yes, option is given like this. So you can think of this way also. Option C is correct for this one. I hope you understand this. Clear, guys? Yeah. This question, you see? Oh, not this one. Okay, try this. Question number 19, question number 20, question number 21. 22 you don't do now. Question number 22 you leave. We have to discuss the graph comparison. In next class we'll do that, and then we can do this also. 90, 20, 21 you try. Done, guys. Achha, done. Only 19, 20, and 21. Follow the relationship with the monotomy. PV to the power gamma constant. Gamma is 5/3. So option A is correct for sure. So 90 is nothing you need to do. 20th one. Gamma value is given mixed with 2 mole of a diatomic gas. The mixture of the value of gamma. See, I'll tell you how to find out the CP of the mixture. I'll tell you. See, we need to find out the gamma of the mixture. So gamma of the mixture would be, again, we'll write down CP by CV. Correct? But we need to find out CP by CV of the mixture. Okay? Of the mixture. So CP of the mixture would be, just see how to find out the mixture CP here, like molar heat capacity at constant pressure. So this would be, we have 2 moles of a diatomic gas and 1 mole of a monatomic gas, right? So we'll write down here, number of moles of a monatomic gas, like we'll write down N1 CP1 plus N2 CP2 divided by N1 plus N2. Did you get it? The formula? CP into the number of moles of that gas. CP into the number of moles of that gas divided by total number of moles, right? So N1 is 1 mole. What is the value of CP for a monatomic gas? It is 5 by 2 R. R, you let it be in terms of R because we have to find out the ratio. R will get cancelled. N2 is 2 mole and CP2 is what? For a diatomic gas, it is 7 by 2 R. We know this. N1 plus N2 is 3. So we have 7 into 2 is 14 plus 9, 5 is 19. 19 by 6 R we have the mixture of CP. Like the mixture, CP of the mixture is this. Similarly, the CV of the mixture we can find out. That would be N1 CV1 plus N2 CV2 divided by 3, N1 plus N2. You can also write down this as the formula. Okay, you can use this as a formula. So N1 is 1 into 3 by 2 R plus 2 into 5 by 2 R divided by 3. So 5 into 2, 10, 10 plus 3 is 13. So 13 by 6 R we have. So gamma of the mixture is what we'll have here. CP by CV is 19 divided by 13. That would be around 1.46. Answer is option B. Clear? Last one, you try. Okay, you see, question number 21, when an ideal diatomic gas is heated at constant pressure, so ideal diatomic gas at constant pressure. So constant pressure means we'll talk about delta H here. Delta H is number of moles is not given. So 1 mole I'll taking. So CP delta D. The fraction of heat supplied when increase the internal energy of the gas. Internal delta U is CV dT. So fraction of heat is what? Delta H by delta T. So you need to find out, when an ideal diatomic gas is this concentration of fraction of heat supplied with increase in internal energy. Okay. So delta U by delta H, we need to find out. That would be CV by CP. What is this? Diatomic gas we have. So for diatomic gas, CV value is 5 by 2R and CP value is 7 by 2R. So 5 by 7, option D is correct. Did you understand this? This question I'm giving you here, you can try this after the class. Only two questions we have. After the class, you can try and you can post your answer on the group. I will share the PDF now. You can attempt these two questions, okay? Try these two questions and post the answer, your attempt, your working on the group now. Okay, these two questions. Fine, so this is it for today. Okay, next class we'll start with the graph comparison. Just heading you write down all of you. Graph comparison, we will do the comparison of the graph of isothermal and adiabatic process and then we'll move on to the next part. Okay, guys. Thank you so much. Take care. Bye. Yeah, try these two questions now and post your answer. You're working quickly.